what do? They bring Ebola victims into the U.S. Never been done before. They leave the borders wide open and fly in record numbers of people from collapsing countries as all of our allies shut down flights. And they spin it and say, well, we've got to have our troops be able to get in to take care of the sick people, when they've had Pentagon generals, both retired and current, come out and say, A, our troops aren't trained. B, they'll just contract it and bring it back here. This is a terrible idea. The Centers for Disease Control and Prevention. And it just illustrates they can't and they won't protect you. And for some reason, they want Ebola to break out in this country. And that's why I'm opening the phones up. I want to know from you out there in this segment and right through into the second hour today, why do you think this is happening? We've got SA Insider from FEMA Region 6, Spiro from Washington, Katie from Boston, Zach in Wisconsin, Cindy, Richard, Julio, Mark, Karen, Jason. Is that Monique? From Quebec, Canada, and many others. And we're going to try to go through your calls quickly to get your question or your comment, and then I will continue to go through all the news I haven't even gotten to yet. Ebola patient in Dallas fighting for his life, the CDC head has said. Remember just a few months ago, I'm like, the government's going to be to blame if they keep bringing these Ebola patients in, and Ebola gets loose in the country, or if they don't ban flights like British Airways has done and like the UK's done. That was a month and a half ago. And they had CBS News stories and just you name it, literally dozens and dozens and dozens saying Alex Jones is a horrible, evil person. He doesn't like black people because he doesn't, you know, he wants to stop the flights. Oh, I'll assure you, if there was a country mainly of white people with Ebola, I wouldn't want him flying here. I mean, this is just no-brainer. No-brainer quarantine. They're going to wait till it spreads and quarantine everybody and forcibly inoculate us. Just get ready. They may not do it this time. This is a beta test, though. Mark my words, they're doing it on purpose. And so I'm to blame. I understand. Let's have some more CNN reports and another Washington Post attack piece like last week. And just because we're so bad, because we say what Governor Jindal said before he said it, that it defies logic to not shut down those flights. And that's what he now says. Because I'm normal, see? I'm actually informed. I actually study things. And I'm actually concerned and involved. And I'm the bad man. That's right. Remember just 4 or 5 years ago, 6 years ago, it was still, oh, that crazy guy thinks the government's corrupt. Ha, ha, ha. Everyone knows the government's just fine. Everyone knows there's no corruption. Oh, yeah. Folks, they have been denying all this to get their system in place. And not everybody in government's bad. But the system has been set up to be very corrupt, and we better collectively turn this around or it's over. Because the political interests just get more power out of crises, more power out of discordia. It's a system of milking chaos, Hegelian dialectics, problem, reaction, solution, a buzzard economy. If you were a buzzard, crony capitalist, anti-free marketer, you're basically a vulture or a buzzard. Now, what do you want? You want happy deer running around the field? No, you want them dead, run over in the streets so you can eat them. And that's basically the type of culture. They have corporate raiders. But they raid whole countries, and they artificially destabilize whole regions. And this is being done here now, so they can pose as saviors. And they'll probably give Obama an award after all this is over for battling Ebola or something. I mean, there's no end to it. It's about overturning reality, waging war on the truth, a war against reality. It's about flaunting corruption. It's about breaking our back, literally urinating on us to mark us as their property, that they can do whatever they want, whenever they want, and laugh at us. This is criminals exercising evil upon us to break our will. I'm done ranting. I'm going to go to your calls throughout the entire next hour. Who should we talk to first here? I don't think I want to talk to Monique. You want to go to Kathy in Boston first?
Yes, we do.
Okay, Kathy in Boston, you're on the air.
Hi, Alex. I wanted to just tell you that I lived in Dallas and had to relocate to Boston as a medical refugee in 2012 because even though I had insurance, I could not get access to care because I was on Medicare. After working full-time with the high arch foot, going through surgery for that, you know, this and that, and I had no access to health care outside of Medicare. A root canal tooth failed. I know your dad's an oral surgeon, so you can probably, you know, talk to him about this later. I got actin on my coast, is in my face, and part of my face got eaten off. And I was told when I went in, the first person that saw me said, you need to have a CT. We don't want to do anything until we make sure that the extra oral cyst is, you know, not connected to that. So I said, okay, great. She got trumped by the guy in charge, and two people told me they didn't want to take your Medicare. So I began a search to try to find a doctor to accept a new patient on Medicare while this thing was going out of control on my face. And I could not find one. Finally, one in Flanders.
Ma'am, all I can say is we're only taking calls on Ebola right now. That's what you told us. What's your Ebola point?
Well, the Ebola point is this, is that the breakdown of access to care in Dallas is so severe.
Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, listen, states everywhere are collapsing from the 35 million to 40 million illegals that are given first treatment up front. The banks give them bank accounts first, houses first. It's been in the Associated Press to bring the giant population here to devalue the currency and the rest of it. But no, I absolutely hear you. This is all part of becoming a third world nation, is we're going to have third world disease. And then the government will come in with more Obamacare, more federalization as the answer to the crisis they helped create. Sorry to hear about your medical crises. Cindy in Pennsylvania, you're on the air. Go ahead.
Yeah, thanks for taking my call, Alex. I'm just wondering, they don't seem to be panicking in any way, you know, who they are. Everybody else is freaked out about this Ebola thing, but aren't they afraid of it getting into their families? I mean, their families are all over the country. Pelosi, all of them have grandchildren. Obama has to do his fundraisers. Why are they not afraid of catching it?
That's a great point. Thank you for the call. Please remember to turn your radios down, folks, so we can actually hear you. It's because they're definitely orchestrating it, or they're riding the crisis. I mean, there's no ifs, ands, or buts. They have turned off all the defaults to do this, to bring in Ebola-infected people, to not track or quarantine the family when this first happened for 5 days, to just try to have plausible deniability when Ebola starts popping up in other areas. Then the hysteria will start. But they didn't want to get it stopped up front. They wanted to get it in place first. Let's talk to Richard in Arizona. You're on the air. Go ahead.
Yeah, Alex, thank you. I appreciate it. You've talked to me before. I'm an independent health scientist. I've been for about 50 years and working on all these diseases and age reversal, and I'm way outside the system. But I want to tell you just a couple of quick things. One is, you're absolutely correct that it's completely intentional. CDC is not incompetent in any means whatsoever. They're following orders. And the things they're doing are more than obvious just to get it in place in America. And I would suggest that people use whatever time they have to get themselves in really good condition, mentally, emotionally, spiritually, physically, get detoxified, change your lifestyle right now, not later. And don't eat anything or drink anything that's not good for you. Just basic ideas.
Why do you think they want to get Ebola spreading in the country?
I think they intend to wipe out a big chunk of the population on the way to leaving just a few left, which is the people at the very top of the power structure.
Well, Dr. Eric Pianka at UT famously was on national television for his dream of 90% being killed by airborne Ebola to wipe out the scourge of humanity. Prince Philip has said the same thing, Queen Elizabeth's II's husband. And this is what my film Endgame, Blueprint for Global Enslavement, is all about. Great points. Let's go to Julio. One more call before we go to break. You got about a minute, Julio. Go ahead.
You know, it's not a coincidence, Alex, that the mayor of Atlanta, Kasim Reed, would attend the Bilderberg conference this year. I mentioned this on your show.
Yeah, you called in about 2 months ago, and you predicted that they were going to release it in the U.S.
Absolutely. It's not a coincidence. You look at Bilderberg's past, for example, Christine Todd Whitman, an absolute no one from New Jersey. Her role was played as EPA director in New York on 9/11. Look at Rick Perry. Despite a failed presidential attempt, he's playing a big role here in your state, Alex, in Texas.
He went to Bilderberg, too. I tell you what, stay there. I'm going to come back to you, Julio.
From the water table to our soils to the atmosphere itself, our world is becoming more and more toxic each and every day. But it's not just the air outside that's toxic. Indoor air has been shown to have 2 to 5 times higher concentrations of pollutants than even outdoor air. And most Americans spend 90% of their time inside using toxic chemicals within their homes. There are more than 42 million smokers in the United States. Well over 1,000 types of mold and mildew linked to numerous conditions. And don't forget the fact that 6 million Americans live with pets they're allergic to as well. When I began to research these statistics, it was clear to me it was time to start cleansing my lungs in order to combat the toxic environment that we cannot escape, but that we can fight back against. Made with organic and wild cultivated herbs and manufactured in the USA, the new InfoWars Life Lung Cleanse is here in a convenient spray bottle that can be brought with you throughout any toxic environment. Now available exclusively at InfoWarsLife.com or by calling toll-free 888-253-3139.
Hey, now you can watch the Alex Jones Show live as it happens at Infowars.com/show.
Mark's coming up in the next segment. He's got a very interesting point I see on screen about the African Hajj pilgrimage coming up. That's why Saudi Arabia and others have banned these flights. Is they've already had Ebola cases get into their country. It's just amazing, absolutely amazing. And the timing of all this, we played the clip a few weeks ago. I should probably play it again. Our own government messing with monkeys in Ebola created an airborne strain back in 1989. And then later they declassified it and they did a special piece on Nova about it. I mean, this isn't a game. This is not a game. I had 3 family members die in the last 12 months of mystery airborne lung illnesses. And now Obama signs executive orders about martial law and detaining anybody with a respiratory illness 2 months ago. Guys, can you print me that article? I keep forgetting the exact number of it. It's just headline, Obama signs executive order on airborne illness. Obama signs executive order on respiratory illness, on quarantining. And before it said specifically stuff that was bad. Now it's just period. It's all about a power grab. And it doesn't even mean it's going to happen this time. There it is. Obama signs executive order to allow detention of Americans with respiratory illnesses. Amendment comes in wake of Ebola scare. August 1st. So over a month ago. That's 2 months ago. 2 months and 4 days ago. Let's go back to Julio. Julio, go ahead and give us your take on what you think's going on.
I think it's completely orchestrated. It may not happen widespread right away, but again, if you go back and look at all these political actors, including Kasim Reed, it's not a coincidence that these, like Bilderberg, would talk about something like this. And you mentioned that executive order. You know, I work in radio here in Wyoming. I'm originally from Chicago, and I spoke to one of the sales directors, and he told me from a source he has inside the military. He and I joked, and he talked about FEMA camps, and I told him, hey, you sounded like one of those conspiracy theorists. Like he tells me that, here in Wyoming, that they have military facilities, these concentration camps. So in the future, maybe not now, but in the coming years, we are going to see this continuity of government agenda continue to roll out, and they're going to use these crises as a way to an excuse to bring people into sports stadiums or old military facilities. And one last thing, Alex, again, Rick Perry, here in Texas, people need to put his feet to the fire to stop this, because again, his appearance at Bilderberg in 2007 in Istanbul, Turkey, is a clear example that he will not think about Texas first. He will think about the elitists, because he's blackmailed. They have him. And there's no way he's going to do anything for Texas if people don't put his feet to the fire.
He'll put out a lot of rhetoric about shooting coyotes and having guns. But why isn't he calling for Obama to shut down these flights? And why is the CDC allowed to say, oh, we couldn't get medical care to Africa, when those are U.S. military flights going in? No one said cease all the flights. They said passenger flights.
Absolutely, Alex. And again, CDC is based in Atlanta. So This is totally orchestrated, and we need to look at State Department groups, along with Bill and the Melinda Gates Foundation, going to Africa and all those vaccines and the GMO foods they've given the African people. This is a genetically modified society. We're in it right now, Alex, and they're going to roll this out more and more incrementally.
You're absolutely right. Thank you, Julio. If you just joined us, Ebola patient in Dallas fighting for his life, says CDC head. MSNBC says Ebola's worse because of the Second Amendment. You cannot make this up. It's up on Infowars.com. Back in August, we wrote about Obama signs executive order to allow detention of Americans with respiratory illness. He changed an executive order to say that if it was communicable and deadly, they could have a quarantine. Now, this is just saying for any reason, but then they won't quarantine real people that have been exposed to Ebola patients. They won't clean up the vomit off the street, or they do it 6 days later and just have the maid service do it. They won't clean up the hospital equipment. They'll put Ebola patients in regular ward areas in Atlanta, in regular hospitals, not level 4 bioweapon containment facilities. This has never been done before. And it's to train you to accept anything. The question is, why? What are they planning to get out of it? Forced inoculations? Bill and Melinda Gates' new Monsanto Ebola vaccine? I'm not taking it. My grandmother got polio a month after she took the polio vaccine. And so did most of the people she knew that got it. You can actually look into that. That's what's so crazy about this medical system, is it gets away with bloody murder and hides collectively its mistakes, or it's secret testing, or the evil things it's done on purpose. Mark in Oregon, then we'll go to Karen and others. Mark, what's your take on this situation?
Hey, old Alex. God bless you and yours, sir. Alex, you've mentioned several times today that this Ebola crisis may be a beta test. I'm sure you realize that in all probability, given the blatant and intentional negligence that is and has occurred here and will continue to occur, that the intention of the evildoers is to, in short order, create a highly lethal global pandemic.
That's what Ted Turner and Prince Philip and Dr. Pianca and just all the rest of them constantly call for, a wonderful airborne super weapon to cleanse the earth of the disease that is humanity, and that we all shouldn't have kids, but Ted Turner can have five. Yes, I absolutely agree with you.
Everything that you're well aware of, Alex, and that you've, through your service and ministry, have made your audience through the years, which has been ever-growing, is aware of. There's a natural progression in the whole history of these people. I won't call them eugenicists. I think they've established their gene pool quite a while back. I would call them genocidalists. And yes, it leads right up into it. The 21-day average incubation period, during which a person will shed the virus to all who come into contact with that person's bodily fluids, which can be indirectly through a counter surface, to a person sneezing, anything a person touches, it can be on the money. They can actually pick up the Ebola virus on the money, and it's a very long-living virus. And it is a highly lethal super virus, whereas...
And they're just totally calm. They're usually, get all your shots for school or you'll all die. Oh, do whatever you take your mercury. Mercury's good for your brain. Government loves you. Obamacare's free. You didn't build your business. Families are bad. Men are bad. You know, But this is no big deal. Ebola, we're not going to stop any flies. Everything's fine.
Everything is a lie, and when a person learns to see through the illusion which they put up with their propaganda and their mind control in so many various ways, which actually cause a person to believe the broad road of they have control, everything's going to be fine, they'll take care of us, our mommy and our daddy, and it's all been inculcated, but we have many of us who see through it, and I think more of us all the time. But Alex, with the Hajj coming up, over, and I believe it's in Arabia.
Yeah, that's where the Mecca is located.
Yes. And all these people from Africa that are not showing symptoms yet, perhaps some that are beginning to on the way, are going to end up, some several millions of people.
With Muslims from all over the world, tens of millions making the Hajj. For folks that don't know what the Hajj is, you might want to explain to them that it's at least once in your life you're supposed to go to Mecca.
It's the most pilgrimage of the religion of Islam that there is, and it's done once a year, if I'm correct.
Well, I mean, they have the Hajj once a year, the big pilgrimage, but you only have to do it once in your life.
Yes, Alex, and I didn't know that. But they are expecting better than 2 million people on the average, perhaps more, perhaps up to 5 million. I'm not sure that
it'll be way more than that, but yeah.
Really?
Yeah, tens of millions make the Hajj every year.
And we have a mixing pool there that is being brewed up, and we already have one here in the United States, which is being brewed up, and it spreads so quickly.
Well, I think if you don't drink Ebola and give it to your children, you're racist. And I just think you're being Ebola-phobic right now. And I think that you should just, did you hear MSNBC, without giving any reason why, just says that the Second Amendment is to blame for this? Did you know that?
Alex, it's so blatant now, it's quite obvious that they feel that they have total control of the situation. They can lie right in our faces. They know, in other words, in their minds, that we can do nothing about it. But if we put out there such a fact as what Norman Mineta testified to at the 9/11 trials on May 22nd, 1990 or 2003, that he was in the bunker when Dick Cheney was running the stand-down orders and running the whole operation of 9/11, and he testified under oath to the 9/11 commission about that.
No, he did, that there was a stand-down of NORAD. You're absolutely right, and the system got away with that, so why not get away with more? Why not openly fund Al-Qaeda and then have a fake war against them when the public finds out about it? Great points, Mark. I'm going to jam in one more call before we go to break. Karen in Arizona, you're on the air.
Thank you, Alex, for taking my call. I have two mentions about the CDC. I had a disagreement with them in 1971. My husband caught polio, and they wanted me to call everybody and let them know. Then Thursday, I called the CDC and I said, we need to shut down the airports and let nobody coming in. And she says, well, all of Africa? I said, yes, all of Africa. And I said, this is an airborne disease. And I do believe they have a talking point, Alex, that when people call.
Well, of course they do. They've now come out and responded and said it's totally wonderful and that having people come here with Ebola stops it. They said 2 plus 2 equals 50. Go yes. Ahead.
And like I said, when my husband caught polio, they asked, first of all, well, who is he around? I gave them the information, and then they turned right around and said, well, you're going to have to call all these people.
Sure, but what about now? What about now? Yeah, what's your point about now?
I think the now is that I think, what are they going to roll out? What are they going to give? What vaccine are they?
Oh, we know Bill Gates that says he wants to reduce our population by 90%, and he says he supports death panels. We can play the clips. And who is the main funder of gun control, so no Republican dare attack him because they actually work for him, a lot of them. Again, loyal opposition. He's got a shot for you and your family. How's that sound? Don't you want to take what Bill Gates' dad, who heads up Planned Parenthood? I mean, don't you want to take a shot from someone that openly says he wants you 6 feet under? Doesn't that sound like a good idea?
No, it is not, and I'll tell you one thing. I do believe that this is a precursor for something else to come.
Oh, I agree. We'll be back.
Celebrate the spirit of freedom and liberty upon which our nation was founded at InfoWarsShop.com. Molon Lave is ancient Greek for come and take it. This popular design combines both classic Greek Spartan imagery with modern M16 assault rifles, now available in women's tees and proudly made in the USA. And now you can protect yourself from corrupt cops with the InfoWars dash cam. It's your car's black box that records all that the driver sees and hears. And introducing the Block It Pocket. It renders your phone undetectable while protecting your private data and your health. Or take back your privacy and protect your personal information by getting your very own detractor cell phone pouch. So get incredibly high-quality, freedom-based products and help fund the revolution at InfoWarsShop.com.